The Tragedy of Spreading Bosnian Genocide Denial in the Muslim Community is the topic for today. Before I start, please subscribe to my channel and must give your opinion in the comment section below. And watch this video till the end to get the complete information about today's topic. The expanding train of Srebrenica genocide deniers, including the Nobel laureate Peter Henke and academic Noam Chomsky, the Serbian Prime Minister Ana Brnabic, as well as almost all Serbian politicians in Serbia and Bosnia Herzegovina. Our one name in this group weirdly stands out, Sheikh Imran Hussein, a traditionally trained Muslim cleric from Trinidad and Tobago. Hussein has carved his niche mostly with highly speculative interpretations of Islamic apocalyptic texts. He has a global following with more than 200,000 subscribers to his YouTube channel, and his videos are viewed by hundreds of thousands. He has written tens of books in English, some of which has been translated into major world languages. His denial of the Srebrenica genocide may seem outlandish coming from a Muslim scholar, but a close inspection of his works reveal ideas that are as disturbing as they are misleading. Much of Hussein's output centers around interpreting the apocalyptic text from the Quran and Sunnah on the end of times, Akhir al-Zaman. As in other major religious traditions, these texts are highly allegorical in nature, and nobody can claim the certainty, and it's too many. Nobody except Imran Hussein. He habitually dismisses those who disagree with his unwarranted conclusions by accusing them of not thinking properly. A Scottish Muslim scholar, Dr. Suhaib Saeed, also wrote about his tendency in his interpretation that the Dajjal, Antichrist, his American Zionist alliance, the West, or NATO. The Ottomans were oppressors of the Orthodox Christians, who are in turn rightfully hating Islam and Muslims. Sultan Mehmed Fateh was acting on satanic design when he conquered Constantinople. The terrorist attacks of 9/11 were a false flag operation carried out by Mossad and its allies, and yes, the genocide did not take place in Srebrenica. Such conspiratorial thinking is clearly wrong, but is particularly dangerous when dressed in the garb of religious certainty. Hussein frequently presents his opinions as the Islamic view of things. His methodology consists of mixing widely accepted Muslim beliefs with his own stretched interpretations. The wider audience may not be as well versed in Islamic logic of interpretation, so they may not be able to distinguish between legitimate Muslim beliefs and Hussein's own grabbed-up imaginations. In one of his fantastic interpretations, which has much in common with the Christian apologue, the great war that is nuclear in nature is coming, and the Muslims need to align with Russia against the American Zionist alliance. He sees the struggle in Syria as part of a wider apocalypse unfolding in which Assad and Putin are playing a positive role. He stretches the Quranic verses and prophetic sayings to read into them fanciful and extravagant interpretations that are not supported by any established Islamic authority. Hussein does not deny that a terrible massacre happened in Srebrenica. He, however, denies it was a genocide, contradicting thus numerous legal verdicts by the international courts and tribunals established by the United Nations Security Council. The International Criminal Tribunal of the former Yugoslavia delivered the verdict of genocide in 2001 in case of Bosnian Serb General Radislav Krstic. The International Court of Justice (ICJ) in The Hague confirmed in 2007 that genocide took place in Srebrenica. In 2010, two more Bosnian Serb officers were found guilty of committing genocide in Bosnia. The butchers of Srebrenica, Ratko Mladic, was found guilty of genocide in 2017. In spite of this, and displaying his ignorance on nature and definition of genocide, Hussein stated in an interview with the Serbian media, "Srebrenica was not a genocide. That would mean the whole Serbian people wanted to destroy the Muslim people. That never happened. in a meandering and offensive video message to Bosnian Muslims, in which he frequently digressed to talking about the end of times. Hussein explained that Srebrenica was not genocide and the Muslims of Bosnia needed to form an alliance with the Orthodox Serbs. He is obvious to the fact that problems in Bosnia and Herzegovina and in the former Yugoslavia stem not from the Bosniaks' purported unwillingness to form an alliance with the Serbs, but from the aggressive Greater Serbia ideology, which had caused misery and destruction in Bosnia, Slovenia, Croatia, Kosovo. Hussein's views are of course, welcome in Serbia and in Republika Serbia, dominated entity with the Bosnia, where almost all politicians habitually deny that genocide took place in Srebrenica. He had been interviewed multiple times on Serbian television, so where he spewed his views of the Ottoman occupation and crimes against the Serbs. The need to form an alliance between Muslim and Russia and that Srebrenica was not a genocide. His website contains only one entry on Srebrenica, a long expose that claims no genocide took place in Srebrenica, authored by two Serbs, Stefan Karganovic and Alexander Pavic. The special report is a hodgepodge of conspiracy theories, anti-globalization and anti-West views. Karganovic, who received more than $1 million over a six-year period from the government of Bosnian Serb-led Republika Srpska for lobbying efforts in Washington, was recently convicted by the Basic Court of Banja Luka on tax evasion and defamation. The court issued a warrant of Karganovic arrest, but he is still on the loose. True conspirators of the Srebrenica killing, according to Hussein, are not Serbian political and military leaders and soldiers who executed Srebrenica Muslims. The conspirators are unnamed, but it does not make much to understand that he believes that the massacres were ultimately orchestrated by the West, CIA, NATO. Hussein even stated on the Serbian TV that if the people who knew the truth were to come forward, they would be executed to hide what they really happened. Such opinions are bound to add to an already unbearable pain that many survivors of the Srebrenica genocide are experiencing. It is even more painful when Bosniak victims who were killed because they were Muslims are being belittled by an Islamic scholar who seems to be more interested in giving comfort to those who actually perpetrated the heinous crime of genocide than in recognizing the victim's pain. The views are of course welcome in Serbia, Russia and Greece. It is not difficult to see why Hussein's views would be popular in today's an age where misinformation and fake news are propagated even by the world leaders who should know better. A conspirational mindset, mistrust of established facts and undermining of international institutions, there are all hallmarks of the post-truth age. In another time, Imran Hussein would be easily exposed for what he truly is, a charlatan who claims a religious expertise. Today, however, his opinions are amplified by social media and by the people who already question science and established facts. For the reasons he need to be unmasked to safeguard the very religious foundation which he claims to uphold but ultimately undermines. That's all for today. Stay tuned for more videos ahead.